Hello again, everyone. Yes, this is Inside Football, and we are continuing to analyze the historical occasion. Lionel Messi left Barcelona and chose a new club. We have already discussed what awaits Messi at PSG in the upcoming season, but what about Barcelona? The team is having a serious crisis. The reign of Josep Bartomeu had a terrible impact on the state of the club. Now Barca is left without its best player. Many believe this will only lead to negative consequences. If earlier Messi could turn on solo mode to win matches for Barca, for now there will be no footballer to do such a thing. However, oddly enough, there are also positive aspects in Leo's departure. Team collapse or cleansing through suffering. What awaits Barcelona in the upcoming campaign without the legendary Argentinian in the squad? Let's sort everything out in the right order. But before we begin, we want you to give us a like on this video and subscribe to our channel. Here, we are talking only about the most relevant topics and with all the details known. Done? Then we proceed to start. First of all, due to the departure of Messi from Barcelona, there will be some financial changes. The capitalization of PSG is stunning. 250,000 Messi jerseys were sold in the first 5 hours after the official announcement of the transfer. The club's Instagram account has more than doubled in subscribers, and this is just the tip of the iceberg. Although Barca seems to have real problems now. The consulting firm Brand Finance estimates that Barcelona's brand value is potentially 11% lower than the current value. Losses in real money are going on about 137 million euros. The company notes that due to the departure of Messi, Barcelona will lose approximately 77 million euros in sponsorship money, about 17 million euros per match day, and 43 million for the proceeds from the sale of merchandise. And all of that just because of the departure of one player. Considering Barcelona's current financial problems, this is not cool at all. On the other hand though, the absence of Messi noticeably revealed Barcelona's payroll. We remember that in 4 years Leo earned more than half a billion euros at Barca. More than 75 million euros a year were spent on his salary excluding taxes. The team will not carry the heavy burden, so there's a definite plus in Leo's move. Let's see what happens to the squad of Barcelona. Will Messi's departure affect the team's performance so much? It actually will, but not entirely for the worse. Firstly, about the cons. Poor Sergio Aguero. Frankly speaking, his transfer to Barcelona made little sense. He is a good friend of Leo Messi, who was taken to the club to appease the Argentinian, encouraging him to sign a contract. Aguero was taken for free, but he is already quite an aged striker with all the ensuing consequences. Just a couple of days after the news of Messi's departure, Sergio Aguero was injured. Because of it, he could miss up to 2 months of action. What will happen next is not entirely clear, as the recovery may be delayed. Now Barcelona will need to keep Martin Braithwaite with all its might. He can be put at the forefront of the attacking line. According to the Spanish edition Sport, the Catalans wanted to sell the Dane to West Ham, but Braithwaite himself wants to be at Tottenham to replace Harry Kane. Given the injured Aguero and the departed Messi, the sale of Braithwaite right now will force Koeman to come up with some new scheme for the club or urgently look up for reserve youngsters from the academy. Does Barca have someone who can replace Messi? A silly question, of course, but there is an answer. Current lineup of Barcelona can replace Lionel Messi best. According to the results of the study, the Dutchman Memphis Depay, who has just joined Barcelona for free, is the right candidate for the role. Memphis is one of the bright spots in Barcelona's roster. Since his arrival, he has already scored some beautiful goals and may well become the club's attack leader next season. Of course, he will not replace Messi. It is difficult to replace a living football legend anyway, but he will be able to show himself in attack. Felipe Coutinho can get a second chance for a career rebirth. He frankly failed his first spell at Barca. But in the absence of Lionel Messi, Felipe may try to prove himself again. Otherwise, the leadership of Barcelona will find him a new club to unload the payroll. The young talent of Ansu Fati still cannot fully recover. He is deeply concerned about a knee injury. Fati resumed training a few days ago, but he is expected to recover sometime in September. In fact, the kid has been absent since last year's November. A good company of experienced and young players is gathering in the midfield area. But there are also some nuances here. The 18-year-old Barcelona wonderboy Pedri made 73 appearances for the club and various Spanish national teams last season. He just returned from the Tokyo Olympics and rejected his vacation. What a madman! This can potentially bring injuries. After all, he is not made of iron, and at some point he will just get exhausted from playing. Moreover, it may be tough and take a lot of energy to constantly keep the high level that Pedri has. At the start of the season, Frankie de Jong won't help Barca. He was injured and is still recovering. On the other hand, Riqui Puig showed himself well in the preseason. Thus, it is likely that he will finally get his playing minutes in the Spanish National League and be able to make his way to the main squad. Koeman was not particularly fond of adding Puig to the mix last season, but in these circumstances, why not? Sergio Busquets has been slowly losing shape due to his age, but he still has a great pass and lots of experience. There is also a young super talent, Gavi. He just turned 17, and Koeman strongly believes that the guy has even more prospects than the same Puig. And don't forget about Nico Gonzalez, the son of the legendary Deportivo player Fran Gonzalez. He's one of those new wave kiddos who will be betted on. The central midfielder has already managed to impress and make Blaugrana's fans fall in love with his play. He likes Moriba, it's better not to remember this guy anymore. He and his representatives tried to pull off the contract for 3 million euros a year, but in Barca they reasonably showed the guy his place. Either he renews the contract on their terms, or moves to another club this summer for a reasonable price. Otherwise, he won't even be involved in Barca B. It is rather sad to hear, as Elaix seemed promising in the first team. Unfortunately, Barcelona can't get rid of the ballast. Miralem Pjanic and Samuel Umtiti are still in the club, and so far, no one is going to buy them. Pjanic can be taken back to Juventus on loan, but nothing is clear here. This option is only a spare for the Turians, in case they can sign Manuel Locatelli. The Bosnian himself would like to return to Turin very much, thus Miralem's departure is a very likely scenario. Samuel Umtiti could have moved to Besiktas, Monaco or Nice, as reported by the press, but so far these are only rumors, to which even fans of the Turkish club react with laughter. The Frenchman himself seemed to be aiming at leaving after he was harshly booed by fans at the Gamper Cup final. After Messi's departure, the leadership qualities should be shown by Antoine Griezmann. This is who, indeed, was often in the shadow of Leo, and now he can bring his performances to a whole new level. A couple of years ago, Barcelona got Griezmann for 120 million euros, so it's time to work it out for 100%. It's now or never. Griezmann is the new leader of Barcelona and the central figure of the new project. Who do you think will be able to lead Barca in the new season? Write your opinion in the comments below. Don't you think we forgot to mention Ousmane Dembélé? According to the latest information, he agrees to go for a significant reduction in salary in order to sign a new contract. The return of the fragile Frenchman is expected in October or November. As for that moment, Ousmane is another unrevealed star at the Camp Nou. Messi's departure could reveal Dembélé in a completely new way. The main sensation of Barca's preseason was 18-year-old Youssouf Demir. The guy was taken for a season in Barca B, but he looked so astonishing in the first team that he will probably get his time there. After all, he's called the Austrian Messi. Untalented guys can be called that. The nightmare of the Catalans is the defensive line. Emerson and Garcia are signed, and this is some sort of a relief for a club that is close to bankruptcy. Dest, Emerson, Roberto, Piqué, Langley, Araujo, Garcia, Mingueza, Alba. Perhaps the absence of Messi in front will make Barca a more monolithic team with an easier approach in terms of pressure and defense. The performance of 18-year-old left-back Alejandro Balde is encouraging. He looked promising in the preseason and will definitely be involved in the new team. Both he and Dest will be Alba's backup. The most important thing now is how Ronald Koeman is going to use that lineup. Last season, he counted on Messi many times and noted that the team with Leo and the team without him are different. Now he will have to follow one mode, without Messi in the squad. This is a good opportunity to build a more holistic, possibly more varied team, which will not be centered around one star. The possibility of restructuring appeared for the club. It was already expected to happen, and Messi's departure only accelerated the inevitable. Well, if Koeman fails to cope with the situation, then the arrival of Xavi is not far off the truth. Strangely, the departure of Messi was sorta related to that. Xavi did not want to coach Leo because they played together for a long time, but he just perfectly suits the current team. In fact, there is no need to wait for new transfers. The Catalans haven't yet unloaded the payroll. Only the departure of a number of players and the consent of the players to lower salaries will help. These actions will help Barca fit into the La Liga limit of 65-70% of salary cost from total seasonal income. So far, this figure is 95%. Therefore, Laporta's statements about the new players look more like populism, just like in case of optimism about signing a new contract with Leo Messi. It's difficult to say something about the prospects of Barca in European competitions. It's not yet clear how the club will perform in the domestic arena. PSG and Manchester City became monstrously boosted for the Champions League, so it may be no surprise if any of these clubs will win the main European tournament next season. In the Spanish Championship, though, not only Barca has issues on its back. Mbappe still can't move to Real Madrid. The Parisians are not letting him go, especially since Real will also undergo restructuring with Carlo Ancelotti. Atletico will have the task of defending the title, which is much more difficult than winning it. So, Barcelona will have the toughest games of the season with this team. Besides, Los Colchoneros' transfer campaign looks amazing. The transfer of Rodrigo de Paul is worth it all alone. For the same Spanish Cup, many teams simply put it aside throughout the course of the season, because the tasks in the National League are more important, so Barca can try to win at least this trophy. And then, you never know, maybe they will make some noise in La Liga, to the delight of Leo in Paris. Without its prime legend, and if there are no trophies in the first season without Leo, fans of the Catalans should is enough for a successful fight in all fronts. So far, there are only doubts. Projects of Atletico, Real, and the same Sevilla are not worse than the project of Barcelona. Therefore, the race for the title will be fiery. Moreover, the scoring actions of Leo Messi will be missing. Argentinian stability generated over 60-70% of the team's scoring action every season. It's like with the departure of Ronaldo from Real. Since Ronaldo left, those 40-50 goals that the Portuguese consistently scored along the season disappeared somewhere. The departure of the GOAT can't go unnoticed, and therefore Barca fans should get ready for a long, intense, and emotionally tiring season. We only know one thing for sure, it will be extremely interesting to follow Barcelona in the 2021-22 season. Well, it was Inside Football. We watch football from a different angle. Have a nice one, and see you in a bit.